Welcome back to the Talk Around Town Show. We're joined by Nathan Porterfield from Unite for Freedom International. Nathan, what is Unite for Freedom International?
We are a nonprofit organization that is focused on combating the global sex trade. So we are headquartered here in Arizona, but we have a smaller office in Washington, D.C. and an international office in Ukraine.
So you're the executive director. That comes with, the name is a big thing to have.
A big responsibility.
What does your position actually entail?
So I actually have two roles in my organization. So one would be president of domestic operations, and the other would be executive director, CEO, however you want to say it. So as president of domestic operations, I oversee all programs that we run here in the States, and I help orchestrate those programs, and I help to facilitate them and to get people involved with them, and just really develop like what it is we do here in the States. So as CEO, though, I oversee all our international operations. So we have a office in Ukraine that does a lot of the same things that we do here in the States. So I act merely as a supervisor there, giving them direction, oversight, approval to do big things that they want to do, those kind of things.
So how involved is the charity? Like, what exactly do you guys do?
We combat human trafficking by prevention, awareness, rescue, and rehabilitation.
So pretty much a full scale.
Yeah, because we're very holistic in that sense. One of our big things is that we don't want to just provide services, but we also want to provide transformation that would really help change the systems of society that are fueling the sex trade. So we want to, we don't want to do this for the rest of our life. We'd rather see this end and then, call it quits.
It doesn't seem like a lot of people know about the sex trade industry. And Seth had mentioned when he was on our show, with the Seth Beard Challenge that we're doing, shaving his beard, raising money for you guys. He had mentioned that the Super Bowl is the largest sex trafficking event.
Really?
Is that actually true?
It's been rumored, yeah. I believe it's true. There's been different reports saying different things, but I would put my money on it.
So, but how does that work?
So the reason why it's such a big event for sex trafficking is because you have people who are coming all across the nation to one location. Mm-hmm. And, when the Super Bowl comes to a town, there's a lot of festivities and events that come. And so it becomes kind of like a Vegas mindset of going to a town, wanting to party, wanting to have a good time. Mm-hmm. So traffickers, they take advantage of that fact and they bring girls here. Okay. And they,
Think they can get away with it since there's so many people.
So trafficking, that's, I get chills just thinking about it. It's disgusting. But so people get kidnapped then? Is that how it starts?
Or there's different ways that they get involved. Kidnapping is definitely one of them. But one of the most common ruses that we found is the ruse of a boyfriend. Mm-hmm. So a guy comes in, he says that he's all this, he's the perfect guy for them, pretty much. And then he convinces them to sell their body for sex once they've created a codependent relationship.
So what should girls watch out for when it comes to that?
They really need to watch out for guys who are trying to, they appear too good to be true.
Okay.
And then they also begin to start this process of isolating them from their friends and from their family members, start creating a really sense of secrecy between in their relationship.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Wow. So it doesn't seem like your victims that you find, in some cases, even know they're victims then, right?
A lot of them don't. Most of them don't self-identify.
Wow.
With the whole industry, the industry as a whole, would you say, how do you find your victims, actually? That's really the real question that I'm getting at. How do you find these people and help them?
To be honest, a lot of the victims and places that we have found, operating as brothels here in Arizona, we actually discovered by accident. It was just through our daily grind in life. And that's really what inspired us to create the Freedom Generation app. Mm-hmm. Now, this is a app that any person can download. It's a free app available on iTunes, available for Android, Windows 8 phone. And really what this app does, it gives people the knowledge on how to identify these victims in their daily life. So, we have resources on there to help people identify traffickers who are trying to pick up girls in the mall.
Mm-hmm.
Resources on there to help hotel employees to see it happening in their hotel. Resources to help people in the airports to see a girl who might be transported to another city to be trafficked. So, if you go to a mall, if you use the airport, or if you go to a hotel, this is definitely an app that you need to download. It's just an app that you need to download because
is the app for victims themselves, or is it for if you know someone that might be a victim?
It's both, because a person can use this app to get themselves out of the life. It's not just information, mm-hmm. but it's also a report app as well. So people can report tips on okay. there. And we have connections with various police units so that we could actually get help to the girls. Okay.
So you're really deep-seated in the community, which is amazing. And, you know, something of this scale obviously takes a lot of money, which is why we're trying to raise money for you guys through Cessbeard Challenge. Which, okay, so for viewers who are just tuning in, Nathan he has a great cause going, a great foundation, actually. So with Seth, and watch our previous episodes for that, or just look up hashtag Seth's Beard Challenge. Our friend Seth has been growing his beard for about 6 months now, mm-hmm. I think, right? 6 months. So it's a big, bushy, full beard, like the perfect beard that no one wanted to get rid of. So we're actually going to shave it on the show next week if we raise $1,500. So Nathan, thank you for talking to us about all that. If you want to donate, really any amount helps, right?
Oh, yeah.
Even if it's just a couple cents. We're taking checks right now, and it is a charitable donation, so people who donate will get one of the things in the mail, right?
Yeah.
From the organization. So write a check to Unite for Freedom International and mail it to our P.O. box so we can keep track of them, which is Post Office Box number 1702, Sun City, Arizona. But address the check to Unite for Freedom International. And then at the end of the year, we'll tally up how much we actually got, shave Seth's beard, and then send the checks to you guys. So more time, give me the name of that app.
Freedom Generation.
Okay.
And when the challenge is over, where can people donate after the challenge?
Just all over, yeah. All the year round.
Just in general.
Yeah, so it's unite-for-freedom.org. But if you download the app, the first tab, you're going to see all these different organizations. Ours is at the very bottom. Okay. And you could go, you could click on it, learn a little bit more about what we do, and you could actually visit our website and download, you know, and donate on the app itself.
Okay.
Wow. Well, thank you so much, Nathan. It was great having you.
Thank you.
And guys, we're going to cut to commercial, and when we come back, I actually have a technology package to lighten things up a little bit. So we're going to take a look at copy-fast printing and the behind-the-scenes, if you will, of the printing industry. So stay tuned and we'll be right back.